Puff sleeve shirt. Load the avatar, then add the default t-shirt to the 3D workspace. Use auto fitting to automatically alter the patterns to fit the avatar. Toggle opaque surface to check the fit of the garment. Hold down the control key and drag the point to move it along the slope. Right-click to input a specific value for moving a point. Make sure the shoulder line length matches. Now the t-shirt has narrower shoulders. Adjust the armhole line to make the curve more pronounced. This will make the garment tighter. Move the point lower to increase the front neck drop. Adjust the points to make the corner of the pattern a right angle. Adjust the point to edit the shoulder line until it fits the avatar. Delete any unnecessary points and drag the segment to make the sleeve longer. The sleeve pattern meshes are intersecting now that the length has been increased. We need to rearrange the pattern pieces. Use offset pattern outline to make the placket pattern. Select extend as side segment type to extend the outlines along the slope. To avoid collision, move this pattern in front of the other. Since we're going to add buttons, delete the center sewing line. Use the smooth curve tool to turn the round out the corner. Create a button, then use the Select Move Button tool to copy and paste the button. When pasting the button, right-click to input the specific value for the paste offset. You can duplicate the button to the symmetrical pattern. Then you can choose to convert the buttons on any side into buttonholes. Select the buttons, then click on the first buttonhole to fasten them. Adjust the center line to increase its length, and add a curve point to turn it into a smooth curve. Add a curve point and move it to shape the corner into a right angle. Select Line, 3D Pattern, and click on the armhole to create the starting point. Hold down the Control key, then click to create a curve point. Double-click on the pattern outline to finish the 3D line. Use the Edit Line 3D Pattern tool then drag the point to edit the curve. Both ends of the line meet the pattern outline, so we can use cut and sew to cut it. You can check the gray line in the 2D window to see if the 3D line is misshapen. If it is, you can choose Trace as internal shape, then edit the curve points. You can merge the segments based on the sewing lines. Add a curve point on the sideline of body pattern, then edit it to fit the body shape. The side curve needs to be concave in order to match the waist curvature. Use offset as internal line to create the cut line, then cut the cuff off. Drag the marquee box to adjust the pattern to be narrower. Widen the sleeve pattern to make a puff sleeve. Using the slash and spread tool, click the middle of the bottom line, then click the middle of the sleeve crown. Click the slash line to spread or slash the pattern on both sides. Now the sleeve crown will have more fabric. Delete these segment points to keep bottom line horizontal. Delete the previous sewing lines now that the pattern has been spread. Create the first half of the sewing line on the sleeve crown. Then hold down the Shift key while clicking to create sewing lines on the armhole line to make the second half. Freeze the body patterns to anchor them in the 3D window. Select the armhole lines and toggle Elastic On, then change the ratio to 100 to avoid stretching. Apply Bond on the sleeve cuff to maintain its shape and avoid stretching. Drag the silk, crepide, chine asset onto the fabric, then simulate. Load the pants into the project. Adjust the shrinkage weft of the body patterns to a lower value. Deactivate the pants and simulate. The shirt is now tight. Then freeze the shirt to anchor it. Apply a higher layer value to the pants and simulate. Now the pants are outside of the shirt. Delete the button to avoid collision. Then freeze the pants and unfreeze the shirt. Change the shrinkage back to 100%, then simulate. After the garments are stable, change the layer value back to 0.